There's always a lot of things happening in the Microsoft SQL security space. Learn all about the things that have been released recently this week on Data Exposed. Hi, I'm Anna Hoffman, and welcome to this episode of Data Exposed. Today, we're going to be talking about what's new in the security space for SQL, and I have two very special guests joining us from the SQL Security Product Group, Andreas and Peter. Thanks so much for coming on the show.
Yeah, of course.
Awesome. We're excited to have you guys here. And, you know, as we look at this screen, like, man, there's a lot of things in the security framework for SQL that we have available for customers. And that's kind of all the things that you see here. But also, there's a lot of new things. So everything yellow here is something we've done something new in the past couple months or year or whatever. But today I just wanted to take some time to kind of go through kind of like a speed round of all the things new in SQL security. Are you guys up for that?
Oh, of course, that's why we're here.
Okay, all right. So starting with authentication and access management, what's new?
All right, yeah, that's my area. So in the permission system of SQL Server, we kind of combined our forces when we worked on the external access control functionality, which is purview-based data governance. So we have an external service where you can create policies to govern or to grant access to SQL database, Azure SQL, SQL Server and Arc, or managed instance even. And because of this, this work doing in conjunction for purview policies, we also did the same work in the SQL permission system. So we were able to improve some of the permission checks, meaning we could lower permission checks for DBCC commands, not anymore a bit under sysadmin privileges. We have specific privileges for several DBCC commands. And we even extend the permission system to very granular manage what a person can do, a support person, with extended event sessions. So you can allow somebody to create sessions or just change sessions, but not drop session or just things like that. So the granularity of the permission system has been gotten a big increase, about 30-ish new permissions in that space alone.
Yeah. Amazing, awesome. It's great to see these. And I know you've done a blog series on the principles of least privilege, right? And this kind of plays into that work, right?
Exactly, that's what it's for, yeah.
Awesome, mm-hmm. Cool. Okay, speed round, we're going on to data protection. Peter, tell us about what's new in data protection.
Yeah, let's start with always encrypted. So we made a lot of investments in the last couple of months. So we have always encrypted with secure enclaves. It's all about protecting sensitive information inside your tables. It's column encryption that we're actually doing. The improvements that we've done there is for SGX enclaves. We increased the number of vCores from 8, which was kind of low, but currently we have up to 40 vCores, which okay. allows our customers to, that require high CPU and memory usage. And on top of that, they also require encryption. They can now use SGX enclaves. The second improvement that we've done is on software-based enclave type, which is the VBS enclave. This is completely new. You don't need to have any specific hardware. Nice. It's completely for free, and it's really easy. You just need to enable the enclave, and you're good to go with always encrypted. On top of that, we did some, or we added some extra functionality in the tooling as well. So SSMS has an always encrypted wizard. We made a lot of improvements there so that it also supports the enclaves right now. And the same for the PowerShell commands. So they didn't support enclaves, now they do.
Awesome,
yeah.
Great.
TDE, Andreas?
Yeah, I can say a few words about TDE. So transparent data encryption. Our focus in this year, 2023, was on granularity, of allowing individual TDE protectors per database on database level TDEs. And also to support ISVs better, you can have the TDE certificate stored in a separate tenant from the actual database that is using it. So you can sort of lay it out for different customers on different database, have different TDE protectors, and even have the AKV support in an external tenant. And in addition to that, we worked on the management meaning you can now enable the auto-rotation policy in Azure Keyboard, and it, the TDE protector will keep rotating according every time that you have a new protector to update with a new key.
Awesome, cool. Anything else in data protection?
Yeah, for Ledger, it's not really data protection, but also everything related to data integrity. So Ledger was introduced last year in Azure SQL DB and SQL Server. And as a logical next step, we wanted to introduce Ledger in all the flavors. So now Ledger is also available in managed instance. So it has the same
awesome.
The same functionality like in Azure SQL. The Ledger tables are there. So yeah, we're good to go also there.
Good to go. Love yeah. it. Okay, awesome. Okay, moving right along for network security. What's new in this space?
Yeah, we extended the support for private link. We included private link for managed instance, which was formerly only available for SQL database, but customers really asked for that a lot. So we have private link for SQL for managed instance as well now.
Awesome. Yeah, definitely great to see that land. Okay, moving on to data governance. I think we already covered this update. Anything else you want to add?
No, so basically, because of this work that we did there, we extended what the built-in roles or what the roles that you can use with Purview, Microsoft Purview, the DevOps policies. They support more commands now, like extend events management and DBCC, which is the same thing that I changed the permission system for. So that comes together. So basically, the same policies give you more power.
Yeah. Awesome. No, it makes a lot of sense. Okay, and then finally, last but certainly not least, is threat prevention and detection.
All right, you're looking at me, so. So for auditing, this is absolutely critical feature to have enabled on every system. So yeah, it's good that we have some additional improvements there as well. So with auditing, we are now supporting managed instance to connect to the data source. And what is also very interesting, we now have OBO support. OBO is on behalf of token, means technically we are now including a new field in auditing and the audit log, where you can detect the middle tier application, the Entra ID of the middle tier application. So you understand completely the workflow of the end user, the application that in the end led to a given command that you're auditing in your database. So that really completes the story for auditing in a very, very important way.
Awesome, great. And one thing I just want to ask about, you said SQL auditing now supports managed instance. Did you mean managed identities?
Managed identities, sorry.
Okay, no worries. I just want to make sure I understand.
Authentication, yeah.
Awesome, cool. Okay, well, you heard it here first. This is all the things that are new. As you can see, there's a lot of things. Microsoft is constantly investing in the security space so we can have the most secure database on the planet. Any tips or tricks or words of advice to close us out?
Go try it out. It's there. Yeah.
Awesome. Cool. You heard it here first. Go try it out. If you like this episode, go ahead and give it a like, leave us a comment, and let us know what you think. And we hope to see you next time on Data Exposed.